हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द चैनल। आई एम गीता, प्रेजेंटिंग हियर अ सब्जेक्ट सॉफ्टवेयर इंजीनियरिंग एंड वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द यूनिट टू, दैट इज द सेकंड यूनिट, एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज सॉफ्टवेयर क्वालिटी मेजर्स। सो इन द लास्ट वीडियो वी डिस्कस अबाउट द मेजर मेट्रिक्स एंड इंडिकेटर्स, मेट्रिक्स फॉर द प्रोसेस एंड द प्रोजेक्ट्स, सॉफ्टवेयर मेजरमेंट्स, एंड नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द सॉफ्टवेयर क्वालिटी मेजर्स। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। सो वॉट इज सॉफ्टवेयर क्वालिटी मेजर्स? So quantitative code quality metrics measures features like maintainability, readability, clarity, efficiency and the documentation. So the software quality measures, that is a indirect measures we can say, that the indirect measure, that is the functionality, what is the extendability or the availability of the particular data or the maintainability. This is the quantitative code quality metrics which we are verify in the particular software quality measurement. After that, this matrix allow how easy the code is to read, understand, and if it is written according to the coding standards. Means we can verify or we can check the particular information related to the is it the coding is proper readable or not, is it the coding is understandable or not, and is it the proper protocols which we are followed as per the rules or per the standard, that is the coding standard. This is about this software quality measures. So this is the diagrammatic representation of software quality measures. As you can see, common software quality metrics connected with the number of fields, that is that it may be occur, that is the field bugs, code churn, static analysis, bug arrival rate, performance error or the test failures or the number of lines or the files, etc. Means that these are the all the defects or the factors or the parameters we can say which allows us to check the coding as per the or the check the application system or test application system as per these attributes. So as per these attributes we can finalize how the error or the risk we can resolve. This is the overall graphical representation of software quality measurements. After that, what are the software quality measurements or the parameters of software quality measurement? That is the correctness, measurement, integrity and the usability. These are the software quality measurements parameters where in the correctness, the adherence to the specification that determine how the user can interact with the software and the how the software should behave when it's used correctly. Means in this correctness, we reconfirm the all the requests from the, which are accepted from the users. This is the confirmance of the all the requirements and how the user is going to use that application and how the application is behave while using. So this is up to the correctness. After that, measurement. A measurement is an the manifestation of the size, quantity, amount or the dimension of a particular attributes of a product or the process. Measurements, in other hand, we can say measurement is the act of determining the measure or the point-to-point results which we access from the point-to-point results. So this is about the measurement, that is the act of determining measures. So a measurement is the manifestation or the manifestation of the size, quantity, amount or the dimension of a particular attributes of a product or the process. After that, integrity. That integrity involves maintaining the consistency, accuracy and the trustworthiness of the data over its entire life cycle. While using this particular software development life cycle, with the help of integrity, we can provide a proper accuracy related to the software application or the trustworthiness related to the data over the entire cycle, that is life cycle. After that, usability. What is usability? Usability refers to the quality of user's experience when the interacting with the products or the system. So, usability includes websites, software, devices or the applications. Usability is about effectiveness, efficiency and the overall satisfaction of the user. So, this is about the usability, how we can use a particular application as per how we can follow a particular usability as per the software application. After that, this is the quality measurements diagrammatic representation where we can follow particular quality of the software, how we can improve this quality software or the how we can provide a proper parameters, how we can follow software quality parameters or the attributes. That is, you can see that is in the rectangle, the product operation, product reservation or the product revision, that is product transition. So product transition in the sense when the process is going to sending any particular information from one location to another location, or we can say a product is going to transit from development phases to the deployment phase. So at the time of transition, we check the portability, reusability and the interoperability. After, in the product operation, we check the parameters like correctness, reliability, usability, integrity and efficiency. And in the product revision, maintainability, flexibility and testability. These all are the parameters or the attributes of software quality measurement. After that, we will see what is software metric or quality metric. So software, that is the quality metric, that is the product and the pre-release and the post-release processes. So what is project? That is software quality metrics acquire, that is the main focus of software is, or the software engineering is on the quality focus. So how we can gain a particular quality, that is as per the product, as per the pre-release and post-release processes and the project. So the product characteristics, process characteristics and the project characteristics can follow a particular software quality, and we can follow that metric, that is a quality matrix. So in the software matrix or the quality matrix, we follow the data collection, how we are going to integrate in a particular data or the information, etc. So after the software matrix, software product, that is the all the deliverables, focus has been on the code, but interested in all artifacts. So we have to focus on the particular software product. So we have to follow all the protocols for software implementation process. After that, product matrix includes concerns of complexity, performance, size and the quality, etc. So product matrix include concerns like how we can provide a proper complexity, how we can improve the performance of the software, how we can follow the functional point, that is the size we can say, and the we'll talk about this more, about the quality, means how our software application improve its quality and how we are providing a particular software application, that is the quality focus. After that, pre-release and post-release processes. The pre-release and post-release processes focus has been on the pre-release processes. After that, existing starting or the starting points for metric, that is testing and the number of work found. After that, the process metric used to improve on development and support activities. In the pre-release and post-release processes or the process metric include defect removal effectiveness, problem fix response time. So in the cost of the project, that is the project includes the cost, the schedule, HR staffing and the other resources, that is the human resource as we can say. After that, customer satisfaction. Project matrix used to improve productivity, cost, etc. After that, project matrix includes costs such as effort, size, speed, such as size and the time. So project and the processes matrix are often intertwined. After that, product quality matrix, how we can implement or maintain the particular quality of the software product. So what are all the deliverables in the sense, the code and help text, how we can implement a particular software application, how we can enter a particular input. So this is about the code and help text. After the documentation, that is functional documentation or the install documentation or the usage documentation, that is a support to the particular customer as we can say. After, in the requirement or and the design specification, all the related documentation we have to provide to the customer or we have to provide to the user. After that, education in the sense the setup or the configure and the end users. So we are providing such type of deliverables to the software application. After that, test scenario and test cases, how we are going to test the software application. This is the product quality matrix because our main focus is quality of the software. After that, quality questions, mostly intrinsic to the product but affects external customer satisfaction. So when and where it does it fail, how often, how many defect rate. So these all are the rates or the all are the parameters we follow for implementing any software application or improving the quality of the software. So this is about the software metrics or the measure, software quality measures or the software quality metrics. So this is up to this. In the next video, we will discuss further about the new topic. So thank you for being here. Thanks for watching.